Esther, chapter 1. Esther, of course, is the story of the Jewish teenage girl that was taken into the house, the palace of the king of Persia, and how that God used her in a mighty way. But I don't want to preach particularly about Esther. I want to preach about Vashti. Now, I've been preaching for 50 years, and I've never preached a message on Vashti. Who was Vashti? Vashti was the first queen. Esther replaced her. But Vashti has a message. I just never knew it all these years until I was praying one day, and the Holy Spirit spoke to my heart about Vashti. I said, but Lord, what could she say to the church? He said, she can say plenty to the church. Hallelujah. So this is the message of Vashti to us today. And we're going to read about it in chapter 1 of Esther, and starting down about verse number 10. On the seventh day, when the heart of the king was merry wine, he commanded all of these guys, and I'm not going to name them because I'll butcher their names, seven eunuchs who served in the presence of King Ahasuerus, to bring Queen Vashti before the king, wearing her royal crown, in order to show her beauty to the people and the officials. For she was beautiful to behold. But Queen Vashti refused to come at the king's command brought by his eunuchs. Therefore the king was furious, and his anger burned within him. Then the king said to the wise men who understood the times, and said to those closest to him, and he names a bunch of those guys, seven princes of Persia and Media, he says, what shall we do because Vashti did not obey the command of King Ahasuerus brought by the eunuchs? And I won't read any further. I'll stop in verse 15, but the message is they got rid of her. And I want to preach about that today. So let's take our hearts to the throne. Father, we thank you today for the wonderful privilege of being in the house of the Lord this morning. Thank you for your presence that's been evident and real. Thank you for your Holy Spirit today. Thank you that you're with us. Thank you that you never fail us. Thank you that you stand beside us. Help us to be the people that we can honor you, Lord, and that you can honor us. In Jesus' mighty name, and everyone said amen. Amen. Vashti was the queen. Ahasuerus was the king. And there are great lessons that come out of this old ancient text 3,000 years later. It's really a primer, an instruction piece, a roadmap for our lives. First of all, she was a queen. As a queen, she had all rights and privileges. She lived in a palace. She was married to a king. This was no small thing to be the queen of the greatest civilization at that time in the whole world. There was no principality or power like this one. And this picture is of us and the church. The Lord spoke this message to my heart, and he said, tell the people they're Vashti. Tell them that they live in a palace. They're in the kingdom of God. And that the Lord Jesus is the king. And that we have rights and privileges as we rule and reign with the Lord. You know, the Bible says we will rule and reign with Jesus. That we are literally sons and daughters, that we are literally married in by the blood of Jesus into the kingdom of God. How many of you know you're in a great kingdom this morning? You may live in LA, but you're in a greater kingdom than that. You're in the kingdom of God. And one of these days when you take off your earthly house and you go to be with the Lord, you'll know just how great it really was. Amen. We just see through a glass darkly now, but we are children of the kingdom of heaven. We are part of that great kingdom that is going to come to the earth. This earth doesn't belong to Lucifer, and Jesus is going to take it back someday, and he's going to establish righteousness and peace in the whole earth again, and this earth is going to turn into one big huge Garden of Eden, and we, you and I, are going to rule and reign with him. We're all part of the royal family. Hallelujah. Look at somebody and tell them, I'm part of the royal family. Hallelujah. Jesus, you have been adopted into the kingdom of God by the blood of Jesus Christ. And we are like Queen Vashti. You know, she was married to a king, and there was a very clear picture of her that all she had to do was be the queen. All she had to do was fulfill her role as a queen. Now, her role was not just to roam the halls of the palace. Her role was not just to dress up and look beautiful every day. There were actually jobs for her to do, and the king was not asking anything except an ordinary thing for her to come and present herself to these lords and these other men who were rulers of other provinces and other countries. They had come, and the king was proud of the queen, and the king wanted to show her off. He wanted her to have influence over these men. He wanted her to present herself to them so that they could see her beauty, and she would become a great force of influence backing up the king. You know, there comes a time when Jesus is saying to the church, I have adopted you. I've made you a queen. I've put you in the palace of the kingdom. I've blessed you. I've fed you. I've anointed you. I've clothed you. I've given you the goodness of the Lord. I've blessed you with the milk and the honey. I've given you every good thing that you have experienced. And folks, if you're serving the Lord and you're in the palace, you're blessed today. Come on, somebody say amen. Don't hang your head and act like you're some kind of a worn out person. You are a king, you're a queen, you're a prince, you are a blessed one in the kingdom of God, and we are anointed and blessed. Somebody say praise God for that. And as we look at this, we see that Vashti had one role that was asked of her. That is, come and present yourself. Use your influence to influence these other men from other countries. Do something that's asked. And so the king asked of her to come in and present herself before the king and these lords that were there. It was a simple task. It wasn't anything that was out of the ordinary. And she was asked to fulfill her role. I believe the Lord Jesus is saying to the church today, it's time for you to put on your good clothes. It's time for you to go forward. It's time for you to approach the throne of God and to become what God designed us to be. We're not designed just to come to church and to give an offering every week and to say amen at a sermon. We're designed to go in before the king and present ourselves and to fulfill the role that God has placed in our lives. There's a job to do. There's a place to go forward. God is calling the church forward. God is saying, I have a job for you. There's a mission that I have for you to fulfill. It's not just about you and what you want and all of your requests and what you think and how you feel about everything. It's about becoming the people that God needs us to become. It's about standing up and showing up and coming to the fruition of what God wants us to be. God has called us to go in. God has called us to fulfill our role. God has called us to become something for the kingdom of God and to do something for the kingdom of God. Saints, it's time for us to put on our best and to go forward in the name of the Lord. It's time for us to fulfill our role in the kingdom of God. Somebody say amen. I preached in Samoa a message on the weaponized church and how that the church wasn't called just to go to church and sing choruses, but they were to go out into the streets. They were to heal the sick. They were to cast out devils. They were to lay hands on people. They were to do the works of God. And I believe that God is enabling all of the church today. He's saying it's time for you to fulfill your role. It's time for you to not just roam the halls of the palace and say, what else can you bless me with? It's time for you actually to rise up and do something for the kingdom of God. It's time for us to be a weaponized church. We have the authority. We have the blood. We have the atonement. We have the strength. But let's use it for the kingdom of God. Let's pray for the sick. Let's do what God has called us to do. Do you know that God has ordained all of us? God has anointed all of us. Every one of us can do what the Bible says. It's not just for preachers. It's not just for the PhD or the DD or the minister. It's for every child of God. Every believer is called to believe God, to pray for the sick, to minister the word of God, to be light in darkness, to be salt where there is rancor, to be the persons that God has called us to be. Can I hear an amen in the house of God? It's time for us to get aggressive for the things of God. And you have it. You have it. If you've got the blood of Jesus applied to your life. Sometimes we think, oh, I haven't been saved long enough. I don't have enough of the gifts of the Spirit. No, friend, if you've been saved 30 minutes, you got the same authority as a person's been saved 30 years. The same blood of Jesus cleanses from all sin. And if you'll exercise what God has given you, if you'll use what you have, God will do great and mighty things through us. You have that authority. You have that power. You are who God's word says you are. Amen. In Luke 9, Jesus said, go out and heal the sick and cast out devils. And he said, if you drink any deadly thing, in Mark 16, it won't hurt you. If you trample on a serpent or a scorpion, it won't hurt you. He said, I'm going to be with you. I'm enabling you. I'm giving you that strength. We have it. If the blood of Jesus is applied to your life, you're a warrior. You're a giant killer. You're more than you think you are. You've got more than you think you have. You have authority resonant within you. Why don't you bring it up and bring it out? And why don't you tear up that devil? Why don't you take authority over your house? Why don't you take authority over those kids that are rebellious? Why don't you bind up the devil from working in people that you know they need deliverance? Why don't we use what God has given to us? We're not supposed to just parade around and look pretty. We're supposed to be warriors. We're supposed to do like Vashti was supposed to do. Go in and make a difference for these other kings that are presenting themselves. Go in and be the queen you're supposed to be. She refused, and she got thrown out of the palace and lost her position. Never heard from again. And God had an 18-year-old girl already in the palace as a concubine, and he brought her up and out. And God fulfilled the destiny to save the Jewish people through Esther. But my point is that we also are called, and that God wants us to get up and go forward in the name of the Lord. Amen? It's not the power that's in the preacher. It's the power of God that's in the preacher. And the same authority and power of God that's in me is in her. And she can do anything that I can do. Because it's not in me, it's in the power of God. It's the Holy Ghost that's in you. It's the strength of God's word that's in us. So we don't have to worry. Somebody say amen. Resonant within us is the Holy Spirit. Resonant within us is the authority of God. Greater is he that's in us than he that's in the world. But the church is not weaponized. The church has laid down their weapons. And we just let the devil walk on us. We let him talk to our minds. We let him defeat us. We let him oppress us. We let him talk us out of things. We need to refuse. We need to rebuke. We need to take authority. Somebody say, in the name of Jesus. Somebody say, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Who's here this morning that needs a healing? All right. Brother, stand up. Come up here. Hallelujah. The gospel is not the gospel of word. It's the gospel of the demonstration of the Holy Ghost. People are under no obligation to believe anything about Christianity till they see something happen. The Bible says in the book of Acts that when Philip went to Samaria, the people listened with one accord and believed him because they saw the miracles that he did. didn't say they heard the message that he preached. They saw it. The gospel is no gospel if it can't demonstrate the power of God. If we don't see lives changed and bodies healed and drugs taken out of people and child molesting spirits destroyed out of people's lives. If we don't see the supernatural, nobody has any obligation to believe anything we're going to say because it's not in word, it's in power. And everybody here has got it. Come on, somebody say amen. Now, Brother Mahan, I'm not going to pray for you, but I'm going to pick out somebody that is going to pray for you. Amen. Honey, stand up. You, yep. Come up here. Now, this girl loves the Lord. I see her at the altar on Sundays, hands up, crying, praying in the Spirit. How old are you? You're 13. You're just right. Stand this way. There we go. What's your name again?
Manaya.
Oh, yeah. And you love the Lord, don't you? And have you ever prayed for the sick before? Yes? Good. You know all about what to do. Come on. I said, come on. Brother Mahan is a mature man of God, been in this church for many years. He loves God. But if he's got a need and she's got the faith, that's all you need. Age doesn't make any difference. How long you've been saved doesn't make any difference. All that matters is, do you have the faith? Do you believe God? Can you believe? If you can believe, all things are possible. Come on, somebody say amen. It's time the church gets weaponized. It's time that we get our bottles of oil out and start being dangerous to the devil. Come on! Next time the devil pulls up his ugly head and says something, you rebuke him. Take authority over him. Cast him out of your car. Hallelujah! What if it's a person? It's full of the devil. Throw them out too. No. Cast the devil out of the man. If you can't get the devil out of the man, throw them both out. But keep your joy, keep your peace. Somebody say amen. The reason I said that is because they asked Dr. Cho one time, said, what do you do if somebody manifests with a demon in your church? He said, we cast the devil out. They said, what if you can't cast the devil out? He said, then we cast the devil and the man out. But there's no reason not to believe. There's no reason not to see deliverance. There's no reason not to see healing. All God's looking for is a church that'll weaponize itself and get aggressive. Come on, get aggressive spiritually. Somebody say amen. How come we're so strong for ourselves? Self-respect. You disrespected me. You said that to me. How dare you? Who do you think you are? We sound like a barking dog. But when it comes to the things of God and defending heaven's honor, and defending the Word of God and defending the Holy Ghost, we turn into little mice. We chirp and run away. We turn into birds. We fly off. Ooh, the devil. No, there is. Get the bottle of oil and put it in your pocket this week and turn into a weaponized Christian. Somebody say praise the Lord. Somebody say amen. Get going for God. Quit flirting around in the palace and singing songs and looking cute. Get to doing what God's kingdom wants you to do. Become a useful child of God. Become a weaponized Christian that can do something for the kingdom of God. I don't care how old you are. I don't care if you're not perfect. Guess what? I'm not either. None of us are perfect. None of us have all the fruit. None of us have all the gift. None of us have arrived. Paul said, I count not myself to have arrived, But this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind, I press forward to the mark of the high prize of God in Christ Jesus, and I'm going to do what God told me to do. You have that authority. In the name of Jesus, you have that authority. In the name of Jesus, you have the power. If the blood of Jesus is over your life, you have authority over all the works of the devil. Quit laying down and letting the devil roll over you. Stand up. Stand up with the authority of heaven. God will defend you. God will come through. God will answer prayer. God will send angels if necessary. God will get the job done. But he's got to have a church that'll stand up and be counted for him. Hallelujah. We got to be counted for him. We've got to be counted. Quit hiding. Quit running. Quit being afraid. Quit being intimidated. Quit letting the devil tell you lie after lie. He's a liar. He lies. All he does is lie. Amen. And I'm going to tell you, you don't have to feel spiritual to be spiritual. I don't know how this girl feels spiritually this morning. I don't see her trembling under the power, but she doesn't need to. You don't have to feel spiritual to be spiritual. Somebody say, man, I've had the devil attack me in the night. One time when I was in Hawaii, the devil attacked me in the middle of the night. And he hit my body. It was a demon. He hit my body. I came up out of that bed praying in tongues. It was instant, from a dead sleep to shatabakandayanabaka. And my wife came up, it hit her at the same time. We both came up praying in tongues. She said, man, notice how fast the Holy Ghost jumped in on that one. The Holy Ghost will be there for you. It starts with your will. You just have to say, I'm going to pray. God says, hey, we're getting somewhere now. God, I'm praying. God, I'm believing. God, I'm taking authority. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. I said, hallelujah. If you don't pray about it, you deserve what happens to you. Pray over it. Pray over everything. I said, pray over everything. Amen. All right, honey, you ready to pray for this brother? Here, take this oil. Put some on your finger. Amen. God's going to heal him right now. Come on, pray in the name of Jesus.
Dear Heavenly Father, I pray for Brother Mayhem right now, Lord God, that you just heal him. And everything that's going on with him, Lord God, I just hear you heal his body, heal his mind, heal his soul, Lord God. Cleanse him, Lord Father. Cleanse him, Lord. I pray that any problem and trouble that he's going through, Lord God, that you just help him to fight through it, Lord. Help him to be strong this week, Lord God. Help him to always be able to come to you, Lord God, and trust in you this week, Lord. That any problem that he might be facing ahead of time right now in this very moment, Lord God, that you just be with him. Let him feel your presence, Lord God. Let him know you're right by his side fighting with him, Lord. Let him know you're right there with him, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Lord God, I just pray for him, Lord God. We don't know what's going on with him, but you do. You know what's going on with him, Lord God. I just pray for him, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. I pray for him, Lord God. You know his troubles. You know his worries. You know his fears, Lord. Lord God, you're right by his side, Lord God, and let him know that, Lord. Let him know that.
Come on, lift your hands and thank God. Hallelujah. 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 I said hallelujah. 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 Stand with me all over the building. Glory to God. If you need healing, come to the front this morning. If you need a touch from heaven today, you're going through a battle and you need strength. This is the time. This is the moment. Let God do something in your life. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh, la 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 ba, son da ba da 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 ba, ha ra da 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 ba ka. Oh, lift up your hands. The Holy Ghost is in this place. Lift up your hands. The Spirit of God is here. Victory's here. Healing's here. Anointing's here right now. Receive it, receive it, receive it. Receive it, receive it, receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Yay! Oh, receive it right now in the name of Jesus. Yes. Holy Ghost, flow in her right now. Oh, flow in us, Holy Spirit, flow in us, Holy Spirit. In the mighty name of Jesus, sota bayonde, he kanda bayato tola la bahai, yata la basonda barorotoko, he la bakai. There's healing in the house. Oh, there's deliverance in the house. There's victory here this morning. Yay, ala balata tasha tabalanda bahanda. He did it, yonde, ala la la balata balanda. Touch us, Holy Spirit. Touch us, Holy Spirit. Touch us, Holy Spirit. Yea, la 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 balanda bakota bayando la 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 basande. He did yonde, atabayanda la la bahanda la 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 bahai. Yay, da da bayon da balato tore anaye. He did a la bahana la la baka. In the name of Jesus, touch her, touch her, touch her, touch her. Oh, la 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 basunda la la baka. In the name of Jesus, touch him today. Deliverance in the name of Jesus. Son of a lost Sunday. He under la la baka. The anointing breaks every yoke. Under la 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 la. Oh, the anointing breaks every yoke. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Anointing, 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 following us. Halabalanda bakanda la la bahanda. Yepalalalabalasota balanda baka. Anointing flowing us. Anointing flowing us this morning. Baba Sunday. Londa balata palanda la la baka. Yay, anointing flow in us, God. Shenda bala sonda balanda bakande. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Anointing fall on me. Anointing fall on me. Let the power of the Holy Ghost fall on me. Anointing fall on me. Lift your hand and sing it. Anointing fall on me. Anointing fall on me. Let the power of the Holy Ghost fall on me, anointing fall on me. Hallelujah. Can you say amen? Can you say amen? Can you say amen? You're victorious in Jesus today. Amen. Hug somebody. Let them know you love them in Jesus.